Hey guys, it's Lilavit, and today I'm doing a huge beauty haul. It's going to be quite long, so let's get started. This is my all-time favorite serum when it comes to minimizing fine lines and wrinkle. I am so in love with the product, and I do recommend for you to try it out. The next product that I want to talk about is by July. This is the Super 12 and Super 7 set. They are not sold together. You have to buy these things separately. The Super 12 Bounce Cleansing Oil is the double cleansing without the double step. It's hydrating oil cleanser that dissolves makeup and dirt, and in the same time it quenches your skin thanks to 12 powerful antioxidants. And the same goes with the Essence Oil Toner. It combines a toner and a serum into one very lightweight moisturizing essence. The Bounce Oil Mask help with renewing and reboosting the skin. And the Super 7 Hydrating Gel is just a moisturizer that's great for all year round. I will definitely make a more in-depth review on these products later on. Now obviously you're going to ask me, why do I need another cleanser? This is the Blueberry Bounce Gentle Cleanser. Unlike the other cleanser, this is a 3-in-1 Bounce Makeup Eraser, Cleanser, and Deep Clarifying Mask that help hydrate the skin without stripping it. What I love about it is the deep clean feeling. It definitely feels so hydrating. It literally would melt my makeup off, and it feels so smooth. And the reason why is because this is the holy grail of hydration. With the hyaluronic acid in the product, it deeply moisturizes and keeps the skin feeling so supple. The next product that I want to talk about is the Glow Recipe Avocado Melt Sleeping Mask. Because I love their watermelon melt mask so much, when they came up with the avocado, I just had to give it a try. Unlike the watermelon, the avocado is a lot more thicker and it's not as runny. I am a subscriber for Meme Box, so I got this full set for $40. However, you can buy this at Ulta. They do sell these pieces separately. For example, the unicorn headband is like $9, the brush was like $8. In the product itself, the I Do Care Sugar Kitten Hydrating Holographic Peel Off Mask, it is sold for $23 at Ulta. The main ingredient is pearl and ruby powder, which help brighten up the dullness, rose water, which boosts elasticity and calm irritation, and hyaluronic acid, which hydrate and moisturize. I'm a huge fan for Korean beauty product because they're just so natural. This is the Innisfree Intense Hydrating Serum. Unfortunately, this package is no longer available. I know they have this still on the website, but it's not this version. This is just a holiday collection. The next few things that I got is also by Innisfree. It is the Smart Drawing. I got a few color correcting, strobing, as well as blusher. For the color correcting, I picked Apricot Peach as well as Vanilla Green. These two color help conceal under eye circle as well as reduce redness. For the strobing, I chose number 02, which is Peach Light. And for the blusher, I chose Creamy Cherry Blossom Pink. I went a little crazy with a Tony Moly face mask. This is not everything. This is just the first part of the haul. I actually purchased so much more, and I just don't feel the need to show them all on camera. But these are the few that I did record that day. I think I post this online, and so I might as well show you the clip that I do have of it. I think I end up purchasing more than 80 of these masks total. So now you're wondering, why do I need so much? On average, I do 4 face masks a week, and so it does add up. Personally speaking, I don't go shopping very often, so when I do go shopping, I kind of bulk buy everything. So how many of you guys actually realize that face masks expire? If you look in the bottom of the packet somewhere, you'll see this EXP, and it'll tell you which year it's expired. A lot of places I've gone to, the reason why I have to actually buy it in store is I've had this bad experience with Ulta where they were sending me expired product. I don't think they did it on purpose, but that was just a really bad experience. So when it comes to face masks, I like to be in store and pick it out because I have to look at the expiration date before buying. These are the Central Hand and Nail Vitamask. It comes in set of 5. It looks like a glove. You put it on for 15 to 20 minutes and you take it out, pat the rest of the product in, and then you have great nails and amazing cuticles. The next two things that I bought is by Kate Somerville. One is to exfoliate and one is to wash. And yes, I use this as an acne treatment wash. I only use this at night. And the reason being is I have oily skin, and so by the end of the day, my skin does get a little bit too oily, so I do need something a little more rough and less natural. I like using Korean product in the morning, and I like using this at night for the squeaky clean feeling. The next two product is kind of on the pricier, and I want to try it out because I had really good experience with Caviar product. So this is by Janure. This is the brightening peel. You're supposed to use this for 1 to 2 weeks if you want younger looking skin. This you can use morning or night. It is the Lift and Firm serum, and because it's just a nice little essence, you can use it on your face or your neck, and then you follow by your day or night routine product. I had a really positive experience using Clarin Toner, the green bottle, but since I ran out, I decided to try this one with chamomile instead. This is the Kane & Austin Miracle Pad. This is a 20% glycolic acid pad. I use this product to help even up my skin tone as well as to reduce the appearance of age spot and acne. I'm currently really addicted to sugar scrub. I got these at Ulta, and honestly, I don't know how I live without them. They're great for different reasoning, and that's why I bought 4. And the first one I want to talk about is also my favorite. This is the Firming Sugar Scrub. After the pregnancy, now that I'm losing a lot of weight, I noticed that I kind of started to have cellulite, and I'm hoping that this will help firm up my skin. I purchased the charcoal black sugar scrub because it smells so pretty and it also is so moisturizing. Being a new mom, oftentimes I don't really have the time to apply lotion. This product kind of helped me feel more moisturized just in case I don't have the time for the lotion. This is the Tree Hut Detoxifying Body Cleanser. So it's kind of like soap inside of a squeeze bottle. I love the smell, I love how it feels on, and it does come out black, so do be careful with your bathtub. I've been seeing the next product in so many social media profiles, and so I just had to try it out. I will make a more in-depth review after using it for a month. The next purchase that I bought is the Beauty Blender 2 BB Clean. I think it's a great price. I actually bought a total of 4 of these, some to give to my sister, my mom, and some to keep for myself because I do use the sponge quite often and I do love their soap. Juno & Co. Velvet Sponge has going viral on social media, and so I thought, hey, you know what? I'm gonna try it out. I ended up loving it, and so I bought more just to store. Talking about makeup sponge and makeup all-in-one, this is the Lancôme Le Teint Macaron. I think the packaging is just so cute and it's great to have. It comes with 2 blusher, and the color that I'm going to show you is pink and a little corally pink, and I honestly really love it. It's great for spring. On top of that, it also comes with 2 spongy macaron beauty blender. It honestly feels just as soft as the beauty blender, so I'm super excited to try these out. I want to next talk about these Kevin Kwan brushes. I actually purchased it separately, and since I recorded that different day, I split it into 2 different groups. I have purchased this in a full set before, but on a trip, they were stolen. So since I already used that set, I decided that I was gonna go back and purchase the few brushes that I did enjoy from the set, and the link is in the description down below. To watch the review that I have recorded with the original set, I will also link that below on the video somewhere. I purchased all of these at Barney's as well as Saks Fifth Avenue. However, you can also get this at Neiman Marcus. These are my 2 favorite brushes. This is the eye pigment. It's so great at picking up product for my eye, and this is a smudger and eyeliner. I definitely love the eyeliner brush on this. It's super cool. It does pop in and out to open and close. The next brush is by NARS. It's the Mizubake Kabuki brush, and honestly, it's really small. I was expecting something bigger when I opened the package. I wouldn't say I love it, but you know, maybe I'll get around to using it. This is the Billion Dollar Brow. This is the Begin Here kit. It is $93 and you can only buy in their UK website. It's actually a really useful box. I actually opened it and tried it already. I will definitely do a video on it to demonstrate how to use it, and this is what it looks like on the inside. I definitely wouldn't mind buying it again. I actually really like the product, but perhaps I wouldn't pay full price for it. I have hunted online and you can find it cheaper. I'm so excited to share this product with you guys. This is the Velour Lashes. This is the Lash Vanity. I know the price is a little steep, but let me tell you why it's worth it. When I first saw this, I knew I had to have it. I love the way the packaging is, and to be honest, that is the real reason why I bought it. Yes, it does come with beautiful lashes and a light up LED mirror, and I do understand that the price is a little bit heavy, but I plan on replacing all of these pairs with pairs from other companies I actually wear. And yes, that LED mirror, that light up is removable and the battery is on the back. Oh, I don't love all of their lashes, and I know that if you do love their lashes, then it's worth it for you. But for me, I just like the casing, and I like it so much, I bought two. One for the keeping it original, and the other for me to remove and add other lashes that I actually wear from other company. And while we're on the topic of lashes, I purchased quite a few by Blinking Beauty. And when I like something, I like to buy multiple pairs. This is the Luxe Silk Lashes. I actually have four pairs. I only show two on camera because the other two has already been used and I don't like to show what I already used. The other style that I got is Baby Doll. And I also got four of these pairs also. These two is already in my velour box. That's why I don't have the box for them anymore. If you would like to see my full lash collection, don't forget to drop me a comment or request down below. I actually made two purchases of this set. I bought this one second, but I'm going to show it first because this is my favorite. This is a Dyson Supersonic with the extra, I don't know how to say the word, but I think Y, hair care. And it's just nice that, you know, combined is only $3.99. But I'm going to first show you what is included within this big box. There are the texture hairspray, the memory mist, as well as the rose and hair body oil and the leave-in conditioner. I love this hair set and all, however I don't like that this blow dryer is in black, so I actually went to Ulta and I bought it in white separately. The black Dyson Supersonic that come with this hair bunches right here, you can buy that at Sephora for the same price that you get at Ulta without the Y hair care set in any color you would like. The next bottle perfume I got at Ulta, it's the Beautiful, it's a 3.4 ounce, this is the largest size it come in. And the special that they had going on were these candles. The next few bottles were purchased at fragrancenet.com. I recently found this website and I'm so in love with their perfume. I was hesitant at first, but after purchasing and comparing it in store, they are legit. And the perfume are not knockoff. I love that the perfume is at a discount price and I got my order really, really quickly. I will never purchase perfume anywhere else because the site is so amazing and I guarantee you, you won't find perfume cheaper anywhere else. So I felt pretty good that I saved myself some money. The link will be down below. Check it out. Alright, so moving on to the makeup section of the video, this is the Kat Von D Locket Powder in the color Peach. It was just something that I saw in store. I liked it, so I'm going to try it out. You'll definitely see me try it out in the future makeup video. This is the Fenty Beauty by Rihanna, the Pro Filter Instant Retouch Setting Powder. I really want to try it out in the color Banana. The packaging is quite beautiful and it's really affordable in my opinion. If this works out for me, I definitely am going to replace my La Mer with this product instead. This is the Bobbi Brown Limited Edition To Go Sherman Brick Trio. It is sold out everywhere now, but I'm pretty sure if you look really hard, you can still find online. I tried really hard to try to find the link for you, and I hope that the link doesn't expire by the time I upload this video. After using it, I do highly recommend it. It actually looks so good on, so go ahead and check it out in the link down below. This is the Kat Von D Fetish Blush and Highlighter Palette. I saw it and I thought, hey, this would be kind of nice to just try out whenever I'm doing something cool, maybe a fairy makeup look. But I really love the outer cover. It's kind of like leather. It is super bright and so high pigmented. It's also on sale, so check it out on the Sephora website. The next two palettes are kind of the same. This is the Kat Von D Shade Light Glimmer Eye Palette, and it looks just like the Light Eye Contour Palette, except the color in here has a glimmer to it, so every color in here sparkle a little bit. The swatch video as well as the eye makeup video will be up soon, so look out for that. This is the Shade and Light Eye Contour Palette. As you can see, it's the exact replica of the other palette, except all the color here are matted and not shiny. The next palette is actually my favorite palette this spring, and it's by Huda Beauty. This is the new nude eyeshadow palette, and honestly, I have used every color by now, and I freaking love it. Honestly worth every cent, and I will be doing a swatch for this video, so watch out for that video. The color is so true to color, it is so high pigmented, and I just love how easy it blends. I am actually a tad disappointed with this Tarte's Pro Glow and Blush. I didn't like how the color was, I didn't like the texture of it, I honestly thought it was a waste of money. This is the Kevin Kwan, the Neo Limelight Highlighter. The packaging is so beautiful. The product itself is nice. It feels creamy on. It's not chalky. It's just a nice, subtle glow. Next is the Neo Setting Powder. And yes, it's the same size as the last product that you just saw. Same packaging. The only difference is the inside. This Essential Skin Powder Foundation, I got it in the color medium. I plan on using this as a contour base. You can use this wet or dry, you can use a sponge for a full matted coverage, or you can damp the sponge for a lightweight sheer coverage. Moving on, this is the Garden Angel Cream Highlighter. You can use this as a primer to blur a line and perfect the skin. It can be used over the makeup for touch-ups throughout the day. It's a nourishing plant oil that helps soften and hydrate the skin. Next product I got is the Matted Bronzing Veil. It comes in two shades, a Desert Night Matted Deep Warm Bronze or the Desert Day Matted Warm Bronze. The next piece I'm super happy with because I already use it. This is the Mineral Nude Bronzer by Dior. The packaging is so classy. I love it so much, and it's something that I have been grabbing day and night. It's a nice little tan for me. I'm super light, so this color worked just perfectly. I actually ran out of this Chanel Solo Tan de Chanel, and so this is my replacement of it. It took me a really long time to actually finish the first one, so I'm super excited to start this new one. This is the Creamier Bronzer. You actually use this under your makeup. This is the Fenty Beauty by Rihanna. This is the Invisible Matte Blotting Powder. You can get this at Sephora, that's where I got it at. It's a universal blotting powder that absorbs shine and diffuses the look of pores for an instant filter look on the fly. I got it because I like the packaging. I actually ran out of this Givenchy Poudre Premier Matte and Translucent Finish Loose Powder, so this is just a replacement. I've been using this product since 2013. I love it then, I still love it now. This product I use as a finisher veil. I put it on just to help mattify my makeup, or I use this to touch up my makeup whenever I get oily, so this and the Fenty is the same for me. This is the Kevin Kwan Celestial Skin Liquid Lighting. So you use this all over your face to moisturize your skin and add radiance, and it has a delicate highlight. As always, I am late to the game. This is the Fenty Beauty by Rihanna, the primer. My sister uses it, she loves it. So I went out and bought one for me and one for my mother. Next is my favorite purchase for liquid eyeshadow. This is the Stella Enchanted Eye Liquid Set. Unfortunately, I got this at full price, but I did went back and I got another set at a discount price. And since I redid my mother makeup collection, whatever I got for myself, I actually got her the same product. So yeah, I really love the product. I had a few of these before, and so when I noticed they put this into a collection, I just had to get it. And it doesn't disappoint. Another thing that didn't disappoint is the Urban Decay Starfire Heavy Metal Liner Trio. I had a lot of people ask me what I use for underneath my eye for that glittering effect. This is it. This is what I use. Okay, moving on. This is the Becca Macaron Glow Kit, the Shimmering Skin Perfector Press Highlighter Mini Set. It is limited edition and they had it at Sephora, but it's out now. I linked down below where you can still find it. I was so addicted to the Becca highlighter that I got, so when I realized that the set came out, I had to jump on it. I'm not someone who wants to buy everything full size, especially for highlighter, because I don't highlight myself that much, so I really think this is great for me. This is the Fenty Beauty by Rihanna, the Diamond Balm All Over Diamond Veil. I actually use this for my body, so I actually bought more than one. The products stay on pretty well. It does have some fallout. I use it mainly for my body, so I'm not gonna complain. Packaging is phenomenal. I wish that she would create more color, more shade. Next two things I got at Guerlain are the Meteorite Baby Glow. It's great for a luminizing or strobing effect. The two colors I got is Rosy Glow and Golden Glow. I am definitely a Guerlain fan, so you know, I just had to get it because it was so new. I will try this out and then I'll tell you how it goes. It's kind of like a roll-up stick, remind me of a deodorant. I'm not too much of a fan now that I open the packages up. The product on the inside is quite small, so you're not getting more bang for your bucks, okay? Talking about bang for your buck, you need this. And it's still available on certain website. I got this at Sephora. I got the color 3 and 5. This is the Benefit Magical Brow Star Kit. I think it looks so cute. I love the packaging. The Benefit Brow Bar is my go-to for my eyebrows, so when I realized this came out, I'm like, yes, I need it. And for the pricing, it's unbeatable. This is by Benefit Cosmetic. This is the Bad Gal Bang Volumizing Mascara. I've always been using the They're Real, and I want to try this one out. The next product is by Kevin Kwan. This is the Precision Eye Definer. It's automatic self-sharpening. It's 14-hour eyewear. It comes in three different colors: Evergreen, Kombucha, and Vanta, which is black. I purchased Evergreen, which is this thick, as well as Vanta, the black. The next product that I want to talk about is the Gel Brow Pencil. It comes in two different colors: Sheer Brunette and Sheer Dark Brunette. I got both. After using, I noticed it goes on really nice and creamy. I definitely love it and I will repurchase again. Don't judge me, I'm trying these out. The first concealer that I want to talk about is the Laura Mercier Flawless Fusion Ultra Longwear Concealer. I got two color because I wasn't sure which one was mine. The reason why I got it is because I was looking at the research result and so I want to try it out for myself. Packaging wise, I really like the product. I like that it's in a glass-like jar and it's not made of some cheap plastic. Secondly, I have tried it and I noticed it does apply very seamless. It feels really weightless and I definitely would purchase this again and I am keeping both. The next two concealer I got, I'm actually quite excited to use. This is the Fenty Beauty by Rihanna Pro Filter Instant Retouch Concealer. I got it in the color 130 and 140. The packaging is quite chic, it's not cheap, the product itself is heavy, and I really like the coverage. The next concealer is by NARS, it's just a simple NARS concealer. It comes in just one color. Actually, I already own this, I ran out of it, so I'm just buying another one to replace the one that I've already used up. This concealer is a little bit thicker on, I use this for my acne concealing. The next few concealer is also by NARS. These are the Radiance Cream Concealer. And when it comes to concealer, I like to buy more than one shade, one a little darker and one my shade. I've owned these before and I love using it for under my eyes whenever I'm baking. Because I had such a positive experience with NARS, I decided to give their Soft Matte Complete Concealer a try. Once again, I chose Chantilly and Vanilla as my shade. The next product is by Burberry. This is the Eye Color Contour Smoke and Sculpt Pen. The color that I got it in is Natural 100. This is a crease-free and waterproof and all-day finish kind of pen. It helps whenever you want to create a smoky or sculpt eye look. After using it, I plan on buying the other three colors that it also come in. The next product is by Bobbi Brown. I got 3 instant full cover concealer in the color Ivory, Warm Ivory, and Cool Sand. This concealer is very highly concentrated. It's really high pigment and I really liked it. So it's just a replacement for the one I already used up. The last concealer is by Dior. This is the Fix It 2-in-1 Prime and Conceal. I have it in the color 01 Light Beige. So again, I've used this in the past and I really liked it, and since I finished using the last one, this is just a replacement. I love the packaging, that's what I love most about Dior. Yes, you can use this for the eyes, the lips, or the face, however, I mainly use this for my lips. While we're on the lip subject, I might as well show you a few things that I got by Dior. I really love their Dior Lip Glow. I collect every single color available, and these are just a replacement. These are the most used colors, so I ran out of them pretty quick. After I finished using them, I decided to repurchase the 001, which is a color pink, 004, which is coral, and 102, matted raspberry. Well, these are Lip Glow to the Max by Dior. I really love them. I use them by now. But these are new. These are the Dior Lip Glow to the Max. I've never tried this before, so I'm just buying a few to try for myself. I got 3 different colors. They are 201, 211, and 212. They kind of remind me of candy. I love how chic their packaging are, so I wouldn't mind buying more if these work out for me. This is the YSL Plump In Color Plumping Lip Balm. So it's kind of like a chapstick, but it is a lip balm that helps plump your lip. The plumping agent is the black heart in the middle. The exterior, instead of it being gold like the older product, their newer product are in silver, which I like more. It does have a very light color. It's quite sheer in my opinion. There's a total of 6 colors. I was able to purchase 4. The other 2 that I ordered are still on back order, so hopefully that will come in soon and I can make a swatch video for you guys. Continuing with the hydrating and plumping tinted lip balm, these are by Guerlain. This is the Kiss Kiss Rose Lip. I bought it in 3 different colors, 329, 371, and 372. In this group, there's also the Guerlain Love Lip Lipstick. I like it because the inside of the lipstick is a heart, which I find completely cool, and I've never seen that before, so it's just me trying it out. I've always loved the Guerlain exterior. The packaging, I have no complaint about. I have positive experience using Guerlain product lipstick-wise, so that's why I came back and decided to purchase a few of their lipstick as well as their lip balm. I do have intention of buying every single one available and making a swatch video for you guys. And as you can see, the pink packaging one is the lipstick and there's only one color available and it's red. Hopefully they'll come up with more color for me to purchase. The next product is by Bite Beauty. This is the Muse Bouche Lipstick Spice Collection Vault. I definitely will be making a swatch video for this collection very soon, so watch out for that. Even if this looked really big on camera, the actual product inside this lipstick is actually really little. I wouldn't say it's worth the price I purchased it for. This is the Bite Beauty Matte Cream Lip Crayon Collection. I actually purchased the same vault a year ago and I ended up using everything already, so this is just my replacement pack. For this price, I definitely think it's worth it. You do get a lot of product in this little pen. Because it's in a pen-pencil form, it's super easy to apply. Since we began with Asian or Korean beauty product, this is the Holiday Limited Collection by Innisfree. This is my lip balm best collection. So that finished up my huge spring makeup haul. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for being a subscriber. If you like my spring haul, don't forget to thumbs up, drop me a comment down below, and I will see you in the summer makeup haul very soon. If you haven't yet, go ahead and check out these other videos that you might like or you have missed in watching.